my, in my opinion, the biggest difference between Q players and down players, and also the biggest difference between double-digit Q players and single-digit Q players is the reading power. So even if you are godlike in a strategy, if you cannot read double Atari, you cannot win. You know, so for the people who don't like so much to make sume go, I have bad news. getting to Shodan is difficult if you don't make sume go. Okay, so solving ability to solve problems, it's the exercise of the player who wants to become stronger. It's, I think for people who really want to improve, this should be like a daily exercise. Even if you make one sume go every day, it's, if you think 1 year, it's already more than 300 problems, so this starts to count. And in my opinion, it's better to make one problem each day than to make 30 problems in one day and then do nothing for a month. Because this this is about your personal discipline of doing this. And then I would like to point out that there are some important tsume goes that should be your, how to say, you should absolutely know those problems by heart if you want to be a dumb player. So one of those, probably the most important shape is this L shape in the corner. So probably for some people is easy, but for example, my wife, she's around the 3Q now, but she wins sometime against dumb players, but she still has problems with this L shape in the corner. So the knowledge of this shape is essential because it appears very often in Sansan invasions. So, what do you know about this shape?
Dead.
It's dead already. Okay. So then, let's practice just a little bit. Maybe it's boring for some of you, but just a little bit how to kill this shape. So, okay, as black I try, I play here. This should be a knowledge, I mean, you don't need to think about it. This would be like 1 second question. Okay. Then, it was very good that I started this discussion, so. Okay, black will naturally answer. And then? Continue. I call this inner space. The concept of inner space is this liberties in, inside the territory. This defines, this becomes a shape, you know? And then, well, maybe we should review a little bit the dead shapes. So what are the dead shapes? One space inside is always dead. Two is also dead. From three, we get different type of shapes like this. If you capture three stones like this, you know that the group will die. This is also dead shape. So this should cover three. For four we have... If it's like this, this is a live shape. But if it's like this, it's still alive, except what we see here. This is the kind of shape that if you capture and dies. And also for four spaces, what we talk about now in inner spaces, this is also dead shape. Okay, so for fish, are there others? For four? No, I think. Anyway, those are really the typical shapes. And for five, this is the most typical dead shape. And this is what you see here. You see the inner space here has exactly this shape, rotated a little bit, but it's the same. Okay, for five, I think we have also some other possibility. Yeah, like the star, but this is. This is extremely rare that you see this in a real game. So, yeah, this is also dead shape, but this is the most usual. So basically, what you need to know is that all those inner spaces that take this kind of shape, they can die.
Can we see the six?
Ah, you want to see the six?
Yeah.
The six was like... this is still dead, right? Mm-hmm. This is the six. terms of the colors of how do you call this? This light, the when you cross the street.
Traffic light.
Traffic light. Yeah, like if you want to apply this here, if the inner space in inside is less than 5, equal or less than 5, it's red light. If it's 6, it's yellow light. If it's more than 6, it's green light. But it's very, very useful because when you think, okay, is it dangerous for my corner or for my territory or not, just remember this. If it's less than 5, you should be very careful because the space is easily die. So here we have exactly 5 inner spaces, and if white plays in the middle of it, the group is dead. So there's something, for example, with this move also, the group dies if the board is empty. But for example, if we have some stones in the neighborhood, then this move doesn't really kill. Okay, so in this situation, if we kill in the wrong way, so this is important because it's not enough to know how to kill. It's also important to know how to kill properly. In this situation, this move, it's centered to connect towards the outside, so white will need to do something here. And then when black play here, this with this is Mi'ai and black is alive. If we start like this, and play here, even if black captures, white can play here, so not here because there is a cut, we just play like this, and then black is dead. So you see the difference? The wrong way to kill this shape can fail sometimes, but that's why it's important to remember the proper way. Okay, so here, if I play like this and try to leave, so who's next? You? How to kill this? Yes. Very good. Yes, exactly the same principle. So Hane brings that. And there are actually three basic principles very important to know about corner problems. First of all is that you should always reduce the inner space from the outside if you want to kill. Okay, so in this kind of situation, so here we have two ways to reduce, but it's not even necessary to play, this is already dead. But if black tries to increase the inner space, and a mistake that often that double-digit Q players do, they believe that by playing this they give extra chance to the corner, but it's not true. This doesn't increase the space. Only by playing like this you increase the space. If you play here, the opponent can sacrifice and you still have the same amount of space like before. So this inner space, what is inner space? In this situation, for example, all the intersections inside, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, this is the inner space of the group. If it's like this and it's white's turn to play, then the first rule is to always think to reduce the inner space. The second principle is that the two points here, the 2-1 and 1-2 points, they are Mi'ai. If you allow both of them to happen, instantly the group becomes alive. And when everything else fails, there is a third general principle that you should think to play where the opponent played. Okay, so if you follow those three principles and you solve a corner problem, this is very easy. So for example here, if a black tries to leave like this, then first we reduce the space. And now if we just follow the principle of reducing the space, we arrive to this kind of situation. This is making the group alive. But if we follow the principle that the 2-1 points are Mi'ai, we should play here, but it makes black alive. So whenever we tried this and this, black always answered here, so we come to the third principle, just play where the opponent wants to play, but then you arrive to this one. Okay, so, well, there are this kind of trial for black, for example, like this, the 2-1 points are Mi'ai. If you see this, instantly you should consider this one. And then when black plays here, how to kill? How would you kill? The correct way. There is one, two ways to kill now. One is correct and one is not correct. But they both work when the board is like this. We should be careful.
Mm-hmm.
Very good. We follow the first principle that we know, reduce the space from the outside. Okay, thank you very much. And then we play inside and we kill. We can also kill it like this in this particular situation. But as I said, if there is some stone around here on the outside, in a real game, we don't have just a corner. In a real game, we have many stones on the board. And if we are not careful with this kind of move, we can fail, because again, black can play this. And if you go for the kill, black can just play here and connect with the outside stone. You see, so still, there are some particular situations when we can fail. And if black play like this, then obviously we should go for the 2-1 Niai points. So like this, we analyzed all the possible variations, so we reached the conclusion that this shape is already dead. So this knowledge is very important. And then, okay, how about we increase a little bit the inner space of black? What happens now? Is this group dead? Very good. Okay, so let's suppose it's a white stem to play. How do we kill this group? It's very easy, based on the previous discussion. We should reduce it to the shape that we know that is already there. Very good, yes. If we play this, we basically reduce the problem to the L shape in the corner that we know is dead. And from here on, everything black tries, we follow the same things like before. That's everything. So sometimes people try to go inside with complicated stuff, and this can be tricky, sometimes we can miss it. And how about we increase more black space? So this happens in real games a lot as a result of sun invasion. Is this group alive or not? Okay, so the conclusion is like this, it's very simple. The L shape is dead, as it is. If black gets one extension on either side, then black can leave if he plays, and if white plays, white can kill. How to leave? Always we should think about one of these two moves. So this one and this one make good shape. With the other thing is the same, and here if we have both extensions, then this is enough space, so black is normally alive. So if you think in terms of space, if we answer everything like this, we have six inner spaces, and I told you that six is yellow. So six is usually alive, except some damezumari situations in the corner when you can still die. So for example, in this situation, if white plays here, this is a bit tricky. Normally to leave, we need to play like this. And now we need to play here, but this would put black in a tie. So before that, we need to capture one of the stones, and this capture should be sent, otherwise black dies. So if white can afford to play this one, and black cannot escape on the outside, then black will die. So you have to be careful still when there is a six space in the corner. But if it's more than six, from seven on, it's completely safe.